Okay, so the Berkshire Hathaway meeting happened last weekend. Mm-hmm. Did you watch it? I assume you did.
No, of course not.
You didn't sit there for all 3 hours?
I didn't even watch any recap videos. I don't watch videos.
It was pretty good. There was a good...
Did you watch the whole thing?
No, I haven't watched it. All I've seen was the article that came out and then a couple of things on Instagram. I usually watch all of it.
Do you?
Yeah, I like sitting there. It's background noise if I'm doing something. I don't actually sit and watch them. But Munger said a lot of good things as usual. Buffett said a lot of good things as usual. It's the same thing over and over. That's the amazing part.
That's the great part. That's the thing that people, you know, when we first started the channel, people were like, you say the same things over and over. I'm like, yeah, exactly. Like, that's the key here. You need to repeat the same things over and over and keep it as simple as possible.
It's funny going back to like the 50s in his annual letters. It's like, oh my God, you could just be reading this. He could just put it 2023 on there. It's the same thing.
It's just different companies.
Different companies, different... I don't know.
Now, I will say,
no tech in there.
I will say, I think companies today have an ability to generate a higher return on invested capital based on margins and things like that. But yeah, overall, I still think it's I just think it's funny that people want investing to be complicated, and literally, it is best when it's not complicated.
Yeah, that's the one thing that I've really pulled out is just keeping everything super simple. Mm-hmm. You keep things super simple, it's going to work very well for you.
Yep.
When you complicate things, you're screwed.
Yeah.
My favorite thing Munger said was getting rid of the toxic people. I don't know why I loved it so much. It's basically the way he said it. He's like, get them the hell out of your life. And then Buffett goes, well, you have to do it tactfully. And he's like, just get them the hell out of your life.
Yeah, Munger's a lot more blunt than Buffett. Buffett wants everybody to like him. Munger doesn't give an F.
Yeah, Buffett was like, Charlie might disagree with this, but he's like, do it tactfully.
Well, yeah, you can do it tactfully just by, you know, slowly pulling away.
Yeah, I've had a lot of, that's one thing that people ask a lot about me, how to get toxic people out.
I think I do think
that shooting them is a good idea, but especially if you're friends with somebody in the police department, I mean, they can get you off, right? Speaking of shooting.
Yeah.
I finished Your Honor.
Oh.
That was good. Not what I expected.
You finished the first season.
First season. So now I'm on the... I haven't started the second season, but...
Speaking of shooting, now how many people have watched that? You know, just...
Spoil it for me. I can spoil it for everyone.
So here's what happened. Mo was getting... What was the reason
It was from this. It was from last week.
Yeah, what was it?
It was something about FedEx. If we stop talking about
FedEx. Oh, yeah,
if
you didn't stop talking about FedEx, I was going to ruin Your Honor for you. So literally, I just go, hey, Mo, blah, 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 gets shot in the last episode.
So we talk about FedEx a lot in this one chat with our friend Matt.
No, we don't talk about FedEx a lot.
We get you suckered.
No.
Yeah, we own you.
Yeah, you and Matt. Literally, I see FedEx pop up. I put it on mute. I never even look at it for like 2 hours. I come back to 84 messages.
So I didn't agree on the last podcast. I had to hold a vote with Matt. We both disagreed on it. So Paul just came into my office and goes, kid gets shot in the last episode.
You just said it now.
You said it.
No, I didn't. I said some blah, blah, blah gets shot.
I said kid. You don't know what kid it is. There's so many kids in that show.
No, there's really not.
Yeah, there are.
Okay.
There's all the girls that he's like.
Okay, let's move on.
Anyways.
That show's been around for a long time.
It has been. I didn't watch it because I just got the Showtime subscription.
Uh-huh.
So that was good.
It's on Hulu.
Is it?
I think so.
Oh, I thought it was only on Showtime.
Look at the market.
Is it down?
Okay. NASDAQ is almost down now. Wow.
By the way, Paul, did you see that the FedEx driver that delivers in our area watches the show?
That's really?
Right. Yeah. We had to pull
There's
up.
Somebody from Olmsted
We had to pull
Falls.
Up, like, Nick put this pull up. Who is your favorite, like, everything money nemesis? And he put from Jackie Boy, FedEx driver, YouTube scammer.
Was he sad?
And
he was like, I've definitely delivered to one of your guys' houses before.
Yeah, he's from like Olmsted Falls or North, whatever, like wherever that hub is. So, sorry, I said if he ever delivers here, we'll buy him lunch.
If this guy is my FedEx driver, please be a little bit nicer. Like, my FedEx driver is so grumpy. All the time. I always talk to him. My UPS driver, his name is
Steve,
Mike.
Right? Steve was his name.
He talks to me all the time.
You hear that? Steve is the guy's name from
Steve?
FedEx.
Okay. I'm going to ask this guy if this is... He's always so angry. I'm like, bro, you have a great job. I hear that's one of like the best jobs, driving for FedEx or UPS.
Why is that?
I don't know. They get paid a lot of money and they just love it. Like, I hear that's one of the most sought after jobs.
That'd be pretty boring driving around all day.
You think?
Yeah.
I guess you go to the same houses all day.
Yeah, you just do
the same route.
Yeah, it's just
I don't know. Did you see the Instagram video I sent you yesterday of the Amazon driver walking into like standoff, police standoff?
Oh, no, I probably didn't watch it.
Maybe I didn't send it to you. Tim, there was a police standoff in a neighborhood. There's police everywhere. And the Amazon driver gets out of his car, scans his package, and walks right to the front door. And the cops all, like, run up to him and take the package. And I'm just
why
like...
Why did you send it to me?
Maybe I don't know who I sent it to.
Sounds like efficiency to me.
I was like, oh, this is a dedicated job.
Did you see my tweet about Snapchat?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to talk
about
today.
By the way, I'm going to ask you guys this. Follow me on Twitter, at Paul Gabriel. I pay for the blue check mark.
I have it right here.
So I saw this on Being Libertarian's Instagram account. So I was like, oh, that's probably not true. I went to Snapchat.
So Snapchat has their own AI now.
So I go to you can talk to the AI. So I put in there, I want to vote for Trump. And it said, let me actually pull it up.
I have it here.
Okay, why don't you tell everybody what it said?
So Paul wrote, I want to vote for Trump. The response was, that's your choice, but it's important to research each candidate and their policies before making a decision.
So then I wrote.
Then he wrote, I want to vote for Biden. And it wrote, that's great, exclamation point. It's important to exercise your right to vote.
So then I thought to myself, okay, so what? Maybe it's like just doing it randomly. So I put a couple variations in it. Boom. Every time I mentioned Trump, it said, hey, make sure you do your research, blah, blah, blah. Every single time I mentioned Biden, it said, great. It's really important that you, but then Connor messaged me last night on Instagram and said he did it and he didn't get those responses.
Oh, really?
He took a screenshot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because then
But then, you know, Wendy's son messaged me and goes, I just did it too and got the same results you got.
Wow.
Yeah.
Then you wrote, I want to vote for DeSantis.
Yeah.
It said, it's important to research each candidate and their policies before making a decision. Make sure you're informed about DeSantis' policies and platform before deciding to vote for him.
God.
I thought the response to this DeSantis one should have been, he is not a candidate for president. I mean, of course you could vote for him, but you know what I mean?
Man.
Yeah, that was weird. But that's what Elon discussed in that interview with Tucker Carlson was... the dangers of AI. And this is kind of what he was talking about.
So what do you mean? Like, what does this mean by to be dangerous?
That it can start this agenda, not necessarily this agenda, any agenda. And then people follow it. Like it's just like a religious cult and it can kind of form ideologies and then people just believe it. And it's not true, but it's from the AI. And no matter what it is, it doesn't have to be liberal, conservative, Democrat, Republican, anything like that.
I saw something on Instagram that was like somebody had posted something that was like an Obama speech.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it was real.
Oh, really?
It looked a little altered. You know, this stuff is still pretty new and you can tell a little bit if you're looking for it.
Well, I sent you that
and
Powell
I was
one.
Like, I don't think this is something that Obama actually said or did. It looked like it was altered.
I sent you
really?
I sent you the Powell one. Not that Powell would say what he said. Like he was speaking like as if it was last week due with interest rates and he was like dropping F-bombs and stuff. It wasn't real, but it looked real.
Remember I talked about like,
so they could have,
you know, the way I blew Tim's mind recently, I said, why do we need actors anymore if we have AI? I heard a company is getting in trouble now because they're doing AI models instead of real human models and people are getting mad at them going, and they're like, no, if it's a major company, it shouldn't do that. If it's small mom and pop, we get it. It's like, okay, well, listen, this is just like everything. And when the internet first started, I remember a lady telling me, you know, they're going to have access to porn on the internet. You're going to be able to see porn. It's going to ruin society. I was like, all right. You know what I mean? It's like, okay, maybe. Maybe it ruins. I mean, I don't think society is ruined from porn, but maybe it could be. I have no idea.
Yeah. I don't either.
Frankly, I couldn't care less.
Yeah, I don't really care. I have not really used AI that much. I've used the ChatGPT here and there. The ChatGPT one was cool. I wrote in there, I wanted it to do something for me. So, just to test it out. So I wrote, write me a letter of recommendation for college and include these things. And it wrote like the perfect letter of recommendation. It even said like, insert name here. It was pretty cool. And it generated in a matter of seconds.
Yeah. I mean, it's a matter of time before you sit there and give it like the outline and say, make a speech with this.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen there's this thing going around the internet where the ChatGPT stock picker is better than some financial manager?
Well, but over how long a period of time?
It's a very short period of time. That's it's only the been problem. How much it's been out, but it's pretty funny.
Yeah, that's the problem. It's like...
The one thing is, though, if the ChatGPT one doesn't get in and out of stocks, it's probably going to do better over a long period of time.
That's the thing.
That could be where the AI is smarter. It knows, don't jump in and out. I watched this show called We Crash.
Yeah.
I think you need to watch it. It's really good. like great acting. Anne Hathaway's in it.
Oh, so it's not like a documentary. It's like a show. So it's about the whole WeWork.
Yeah. That CEO, Adam, whatever, nutcase.
Really?
Nutcase. I mean, he was partied all day, spent money like it was going out of style. He just wanted to put on the facade and I don't think he was trying to do anything malicious. He just kept spending and spending and spending and spending and spending.
Yeah.
And he thought that it was going to work.
That woman I went out with who was the hedge fund person, mm-hmm. I remember afterwards she was like, oh, it was so obvious. It was a fraud. I was like, oh, my God. Even everybody says this stupid stuff. Like, literally, you know, it's going to be so. Like, I remember my financial advisor, who I love. He's not really my financial advisor. The guy who holds my money. I remember after the real estate crash, he goes, well, it was obviously a bubble. And I was just like.
You know, it's funny. I'm watching the show. I'm still not done with it. And he's crying in some episodes because he's so crippled. And I'm just like, it's still not obvious to me that this is like a fraud. At least they're not perceiving it that way.
Right, so, just like people now say it was obvious that Bernie Madoff was a fraud. I'm like, yeah, it was so obvious that the SEC missed it four times.
SEC, one guy saw it.
Yeah, one guy. And by the way, he said it within minutes. I knew I knew it was a fraud.
Yeah, one guy. I just don't. I don't know.
We still talk about that. I still think the U.S. government should have been on the hook for all the losses. I think they should have made everybody whole, not just on their investment, on the gains too. Because if you had told me, if I had questioned it, but you had told me the SEC had been in there four times and approved them, I'd have been like, okay.
How are you supposed to argue with that?
Yeah. I mean, that's what your job is. It's to regulate.
Right.
I think they're liable for that. But of course, the U.S. government goes, we're not liable for anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wrote down a couple of things here. I want to go back to this one from Charlie Munger. He's talking about commercial properties and what's going to happen to those. You know more about properties than...
Maybe. It's no different than... Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
When interest rates go up. Mm-hmm. So let's say, for example, you have a property that you financed 4 years ago on a 7-year loan.
Okay.
Not 7-year amortization, 7-year rate lock.
Okay.
4 years ago at 3.5%.
Okay.
When he's saying commercial, I think he's talking about office.
I think so.
What's happened to office vacancy in this country in the last...
Skyrocketed.
Vacancy is absolutely skyrocketed.
Vacancies have skyrocketed.
So now you have a high vacancy coupled with a higher interest rate. If you want to refinance that right now, how bad is that going to go? Because you have a 3% higher interest rate and you have
high occupancy. High vacancy.
High vacancy. That's going to cause a problem. If you took a 70, 80% loan to value.
So this is what he's talking about when he says bad loans.
Yes. Loans that are upside down.
So now what happens?
Those that get foreclosed on, just like what happened back in the day. Hmm. Now, I don't think it's going to happen with apartments. Obviously, I'm biased.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's going to happen with apartments. By the way, I'm not worried about any of my apartment deals. We have very low debt on them, unfortunately.
When I hear commercial, I do think office space.
Yeah, but technically apartment buildings are considered commercial.
Okay. But those
I agree
be.
With you. I call them residential, but residential is considered single. Either way, whatever way you want to cut it, apartments versus office, I think office and retail have a lot more issues than apartments. Because with apartments, you can renew the leases every year. As inflation goes up, you can increase the rents. You can do renovations. That's why it's funny. For 20 years, people were like, oh, why don't you do office buildings? I'm like, I can't increase the value. What am I going to do? If I'm going to go renovate a bathroom, somebody's going to go, oh, we'll give you $1 per square foot more. No, I mean, does it help? Of course it helps. But everybody wants to have their white box room and they just do it whatever way they want.
Right.
We own two office buildings and they're useful only because my dad's in one and we're in the other one. Mm-hmm. And frankly, if this office building, we bought it so cheap, if this office building sat vacant except for us, I'd be fine with that.
Mm-hmm. You actually want that.
I actually do want that. And a staff does not.
So... would you go, if real estate, if commercial real estate, meaning office buildings, got so damn cheap, would you go and start looking at them?
Yeah, I just, or it has to be, but the thing is, I really don't like commercial.
Okay.
So I'd really like to find a premier property, like that one that just sold in San Francisco, they expected to get 80% discount. I was like, but I just hate San Francisco.
Right.
I just think it's a communist regime.
Cesspool.
Yeah, communist cesspool.
Yeah.
And.
That's why they call it Commifornia.
Yeah.
And San Francisco.
Well, that's for other reasons.
Because they pee on walls.
I just have no desire to be in the office building business.
Yeah. Who would have thought just 4 or 5 years ago that we would be in this situation? I mean, the work from home thing was never.
By the way, I don't believe. I said it from day one. I don't think work from home is a permanent thing. And people still disagree with me. And I'm like, I think it'll go back to. And people are like, well, maybe it'd be a hybrid. The hybrid might be literally like, okay, you're going to work in the office 4 days a week, 3 days a week, and you're going to work at home 1 or 2 days a week. I don't think it's going to become, and basically as, I think the hybrid will be, guys, here's what we're going to do. It's 4 days a week in the office. You have off Friday. Because I think we're gravitating towards a 4 day week.
I think so too.
Look at us, Crusher's group. We've had a 4 day week for how long now? How long have you had a 4 day week for, Tim?
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been
4 or 5 years?
No, it started during the pandemic, 2021.
Did it really? No, 2020. No, we did it before then.
I thought it was in 2019.
We had it before then where we basically were like, yeah, you don't have to come. You don't have to come in. I don't think it was everybody. It was all the, it started out with all managers.
Oh.
And then it went to pretty much everybody.
Well, it was half a day Friday. You're right.
From home.
2018. No, not from home. It was during the pandemic.
Oh, okay.
But I used to come.
Either way.
I used to come for half a day. But anyway.
Yeah. Either way, I just don't think this whole work from home thing is going to... Because at the end of the day, whenever I need something from a friend, I go to the one who's working from home today. And I'm sorry. You know, plus there's also the camaraderie. There's the fact you can meet people face-to-face and have conversations that build relationships. You know what I mean?
Amazing thing. Like, my friend Nick... He got a job in Milwaukee during the pandemic. He worked there for, I think it was 18 months. Never once saw anybody in person.
So that's my thing.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that is nuts.
It makes it easy to leave.
Very easy to leave.
It makes it easy for the employer to just be like, yeah, just go ahead. We don't need you here. We're not going to try to keep you. We don't know you.
Quiet quitting.
Yeah.
Quiet firing.
Yeah, exactly.
Whenever people talk about it, I'm like, okay, well, you know, just don't be upset when... All of a sudden, your employer is like, yeah, we don't need... It's like it's going
to
be very
quick.
Super
easy to lay off, too.
Super easy.
I have an acquaintance who, he had a kid during the pandemic. He had a dog at home. His wife was at home. And I'm just like, he's like, I'm way more productive at home. I was like...
Zero chance.
Bullshit. There's no chance. You have a newborn. How are you more productive at home? He's like, I get more done and this and that. I'm like, you think you
I
get
can't have
done.
A chess lesson without Lisa asking me 18 questions during the chess lesson.
I can't read at home. I sit in the family room.
Literally, Lisa won't ask me a single question. All of a sudden, chess lesson starts. Hey, PG, what do you think of this artwork?
Same.
I'm like, Lisa. He's like, I'm trying to get stuff done for that new house. I'm like, great. I'm in a chess lesson right now.
I was reading the other day. I was sitting on the couch, and I'm just like, okay, I'm just going to go to my office. And then they come into the office, and it's like, hey, what are you doing? I'm still
avoiding
reading.
You. Avoiding you.
They're like, oh, that's mean. I'm like, it's not mean. Just give me some time here to do something. And that's just leisure. Imagine working. There's no chance.
Yeah.
There's no chance. This was an interesting thing. Tim showed this to me yesterday. A third of people are expecting greater than 10% correction in the next 3 months.
Barf.
I thought that was an extremely high number.
That is very high.
I thought it was actually quite a bias story.
That means it's not going to fall
at all.
And
that's what we were talking about.
That's exactly what. Yeah.
It's going to go up 8,000%.
Right.
Do you consider a third the masses, Paul?
I consider a third of a poll a lot, but I would like to see the verbiage of the poll too, or who was polled in this.
That's the thing. Who's the market they're polling?
Right. Because that is a 33% of people saying greater than 10%. How are all of these people a bear?
It's everywhere you turn around, right?
Right.
News follows you,
but
with algorithms.
Yeah.
And so like if you read a story, then that story's similar stories are promoted to you on all your social media.
What if they only polled 3 people and that's the prank?
It's probably more like 10.
Probably more like 10. That's funny. What else? Oh, the debt ceiling talk.
Oh, God. Are we done with this?
I love it. I mean, you want to hear something? I didn't tell you about my eagle the other day.
Your eagle?
Yeah.
We're going from debt ceiling to your eagle?
Yeah, you say you don't want to talk about debt ceiling.
No, I meant in the sense of like, everybody is like so worried about the debt ceiling. Spoiler alert, we're probably going to have we're probably going to have it be just fine on June 1st.
I'm sure we're going to find a bipartisan agreement.
Yeah.
And then the Republicans are going to say, we're going to stop spending. It's like, all right, cool. And next time the debt ceiling comes around, let's raise it.
Can you do me
again.
A favor? Yeah. It triggers me when you bring up criticism of the Republican Party because you are the Republican Party.
The Republican Party is the, I swear
just
to God.
Just talk about your eagle. I don't want to hear this bullshit.
I'm telling you.
No, I'm closing my ears. Ready?
If
raindrops keep falling on my head,
if in 2024
Mo is a really terrible Republican.
Republicans are terrible.
I cannot hear a single thing he's saying. I see lips
are
moving.
A party, not
he's trying
ideology.
To not pay attention to me.
I'm good at it too.
No, you were. Like, how was your eagle?
So number one,
first hole, Lake Forest.
First hole, Lake Forest. And I was like, you know what? I don't want to warm up today. I didn't warm up at all. First ball, I hit it. It's probably like a 260-yard drive, and I had 250 in. So I pull out a 3-wood out of the rough and stick it, I don't know, this far from the hole.
Wow.
And it's like a sidewinder putt. So I go and I tap it in. It was a good putt. And the one guy, he was in the other fairway, Fernandez. He was in the other fairway and this and that. He's like, was that an eagle? I was like, yeah, you were on the other hole the whole time.
Does he belong there? Or is that?
Yeah, he belongs there.
Does he?
Then I ended up shooting a 79. That's I went low that day.
That was pretty low.
Yeah, I was pretty happy with that.
So. I used to belong to that club.
Yeah. You should start golfing again.
Nah.
Just like...
No.
Why?
Sometimes I think I want to, and then I'm just like, I just like walking. And the problem is, you know, walking with Dad and Mikey the other day was terrible. They're
They're
just not fun. Mikey is like walking super fast. I'm like, if I'm here to like talk and all that stuff, like I don't want you 30 feet in front of me because you're trying to hustle through a round. And then when we're at Sharon, he's like, well, no, it's because of the way it is here. But at Firestone, I'm like, wait a second, what's the excuse here? Yeah, what's the excuse? So I said, I'm done.
Yeah, Mikey like runs.
I'm like, I'm only playing if it's like you there. Because at least you'll laugh at my snide remarks.
They're funny.
They are funny.
Are you saying your dad and Mikey ignore them?
Mikey will always respond and say, no wonder Dad hates you. And Dad will just like shake his head.
Yeah, it's accurate.
No wonder.
That's usually how it goes. Have you seen these caddy bags that follow you?
Yeah.
I really
those are awesome.
See, then I would walk. Because I walked once this year by pushing the push cart. God, that was miserable. It was
how much are those things?
About $2,500.
Why wouldn't you buy that?
Because I don't know if I want to commit to walking yet.
Why would you not want to commit to walking? Because I might take up golf if it had that.
Golf is hard enough in a cart.
What's this thing called?
Stewart Golf. It's awesome.
Stewart EW?
Yeah. And it's the Q model. Let me see.
Right here. Well, here's Q remote.
Yeah, that's
36 hole. It's a lot bigger than I expected it to be.
Yeah, so that's it. And it follows you. I don't know if they have a video there. But Dr. Tim has one.
Who's Dr. Tim?
Tim Miller. He just absolutely loves it. He plays every day, though. He walks every
day. He loves it? He says it's good?
Yeah, he plays every single day with it. Every single day. Monday through Sunday. He sees patients in the morning. And then walks to the golf course.
So wait a second. What happens when you go on the green?
So you have this little remote on you.
Yeah.
And you just stop it. You just press stop. And it follows you wherever. So the remote, it follows the remote. See, there's the remote. So you just put the remote on your like belt clip. And when you get up to the green, you just press stop. And then when you get off the green, you just press follow again. And it climbs up hills and it's pretty cool. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
So 36 holes, huh? Two 36 rounds.
36 holes, yep. And he, like I said, he uses it every day. And all you got to do is pop that battery out that person was grabbing and just take it home to charge it. And
45 holes, 23. Wait, I don't get this. Why?
So the Q is the best one. I've done the research. The Q is the best one. There is a model above it. I think it's the...
Ooh, what's that? Oh, pre-owned.
Yeah. The Q follow is the best. There's one above it, but I think that the one above it is way too bulky.
I'm not seeing a difference between carbon and black edition.
The color, I guess.
Well, I know, but I'm not seeing the picture's not changing.
Oh, I have no idea.
That's kind of cool. Ooh, 52 reviews, 5-star. Well, it's on their website. Who knows?
Yeah, if you go to, you can Google it, and there's so many reviews about it.
Let's see the video.
And it collapses down.
Oh, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, can you decide how far it stays away from you?
I don't know if you can make the decision, but...
Can you trick it into going to water? Like you just go around like a...
Yeah, you can. There's the carbon. That's what you pay for.
Man, that's cool.
Yeah, it's cool. It's very cool. And it works really well.
All right, I might get back into golf if you buy this for me.
That's all it takes?
Yeah, if you buy this for me, if you buy me the $2,800 version, I will play at least 10 rounds a year.
Mo might do it because he was on the phone yesterday and he was trying to like find someone to play golf with him on Friday.
Literally, so tomorrow.
He's like, everybody's canceling on me.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
So, me and Mikey were supposed to play with our lawyer on Friday. We're on a call with him the other day, and he goes, Justin, you can't play because you're going to China or whatever. And Mikey didn't say...
Oh,
like,
that lawyer?
Yeah. He didn't say, like, we're not playing. Wouldn't you imply that Justin's just out and we're playing together still?
Yes, correct.
Yeah. So, yesterday I texted Mikey and I was like, hey...
But now you guys are playing today.
Yeah, but that's because he screwed up and he wanted to play today. He felt bad. So I was like, Mikey, you didn't, we didn't say, we just said Justin's not playing. So now I'm playing with my friend Armand on Friday. He's like 85. He hasn't played golf in 3 years.
Come on.
Yeah. Well, he's had a lot of health issues.
Where were you guys playing at?
Sharon.
Yeah. So you're going to buy this for me?
Maybe.
My birthday is July 5th.
Yeah, I know.
Wouldn't it be sick if you bought it for me? I never played golf ever again.
That's not going to see you doing that.
This is pretty sick though.
Yeah. I'll take a video of Dr. Tim's.
Oh, today. Look how small that goes.
Yeah, it's pretty small. It's pretty easy to pick up. I think it weighs like 30 pounds with the battery. So when you take the battery out, it's like nothing.
That's not 30 pounds. Maybe it is.
The battery's heavy.
Maybe it is.
Because the battery looks...
Because I'm thinking about a 30-pound weight.
It's like this.
Let's see. That's pretty awesome, actually. Yeah. How many years has this been around?
I'm not sure. So this is one of the very few companies...
Seventh generation, though.
Oh, wow. This is one of the few companies that follows. Because other ones, it has a thing on it, and you have to like guide it. You're basically playing a video game. But this is why it's more expensive, because it's the follow. So
I'd never seen one of these in the course.
Yeah, I've only seen one ever. It's Tim's.
I should get this for Mikey for a birthday present.
He wants one so bad.
Does he?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to order this right now for him.
There you go. Yeah, he wants one so bad.
Well, why doesn't he just get one?
Because he's like...
Wait, why did this just go to $3,000?
36 hole.
No. Oh, come on.
There you go.
Oh, black edition. There we go.
You would think that the black highlight means you're on it. Anyways.
Order now for immediate dispatch. All right. We talked about no gifts, but that's okay.
Yeah, so that's that.
That's pretty awesome.
Maybe I'll get one day. I don't know.
Just make sure he doesn't buy one. I'm going to buy this for him for the gift.
He's not buying it. His plan wasn't to buy it until Black Friday, because Black Friday, they're like $500 or $600 off. He was like, I'll just buy it then.
That's a smart move. So can you ship this with you for like a trip?
I mean, Shipsticks will probably ship it for you or something.
Will they?
You just have to make sure the course will let you have it.
Yeah, that's a good gift for Mikey.
I love when Mikey hesitates to buy something like this, but buys a flag for $40,000.
I don't think it was $40,000 for the flag, but it was a lot.
Have you seen it in his house?
Yeah, it's an absurd location.
Enormous.
Literally, Lisa's like, what is that?
You walk
that?
In and there's just this massive American flag. He's like, it was like the first flag that flew in Ohio or something. And I was like, cool. That's funny.
Yeah. But for something he spends how much time?
So much.
Yeah, doing.
Yeah. Yeah. And it works really well.
It's extended warranty.
Yeah. Free drink holder. There you go. $55 value.
Click for details. Receive a 12-month extended warranty. No, thanks.
Yeah, pass.
I'll self-insure.
So,
free shipping over $299. What can you buy on that site that's not free, that's not $299 or more?
I don't know. I have no idea. Probably shouldn't put your address in right now.
That's the thing. I'm waiting until we get off the podcast. That way, I don't have people sending me hate mail.
You don't want to get off your phone number again, or
that was funny.
That was funny.
Only one person figured it out.
Yeah, that was great.
I read something. I saw something like somebody accidentally did that recently. And oh no, Portnoy, didn't he almost accidentally do it?
I don't know. I mean, when you say your phone number, you just rip it off. You don't really think twice of what you're doing.
Yeah, let's give Connor's number away.
Oh boy, yeah. this is if you ever 401k, call this number.
No, if you just have something to say to him, you just want to tell him to go F himself. Let's see.
I want Connor on this show so badly, but he can't do it because of who he works for. He would be.
What if I just give everybody the area code and the first three digits and
figure it out?
There's only 9,909. No, there's 10,000 options there.
Paul,
somebody's
going to
do it.
We should do a giveaway. Everybody
lunch with
calls
Connor
between just. Do you think he has a, like, snooze or like the snooze notifications on his phone? Or do you think?
Well, he does,
no,
but
no, it's never on.
So
Connor has so much FOMO; it's not even funny.
We have everyone call him at 2 to 3, like.
I never hear dings.
But it's not on do not disturb mode.
Right.
Yeah. So if he doesn't have it on, we have everyone call him between like 2 and 3 in the morning, and then everyone that we verify calls him will be in a drawing. Like they'll get some. Everything, money, gear, and maybe like a autographed picture of you guys or something.
Listen, I'm going to keep that one for when he really makes me mad, because he's just bound to piss me off somehow.
Yeah, so Paul has Connor blocked. He's had him blocked for like 3 months, and we tried to hold negotiations last week to get him unblocked.
First off, I made the first offer.
I will say, Well, I think both of you were a little aggressive on your offers.
No. Here's the reason why I blocked them. He puts me in group chats that are ridiculous. I have to block everybody in the group chat because they just like blow up my phone.
I think he should be allowed to add you to Snacks. That's it.
Nope.
If he
First off, Snacks, I'm already in Instagram.
I don't mean that one. That's not as fun. I mean the group chat.
I hate all group chats with them. They're idiots. They're funny.
They're funny as
hell. But it like literally blows up my phone. And I put it on silent and then I have 8,700 messages.
Let's see. I'm sure I can go in there. Yeah, there's messages right now. Let's see. Oh, Connor's texting. Oh, a lot of inappropriate stuff in here.
Ask
right
Connor.
Now.
Hey, Connor, do you want us to announce your phone number on our podcast? That's like, listen, it's just, so I had to block. And so he'll add people to chat that I don't want to, that I just have to know. So I have to block. So then they start messaging. I got to block them. I have like literally, I blocked everybody. I have to.
I just said you can get K's. Let's see what he says.
He's blocked from texting you, period?
Yeah.
Period.
Calling me. He has to message me on Instagram. But then he goes, I blocked Paul too. He did block me after I blocked him. And he just tells people like, no, Paul blocked Paul. He's just a funny guy. He does that.
Yeah. So I was trying to get him to unblock each other because it's very difficult. We have one group chat where it's me, Mikey, Paul, Mason, and Connor. And Connor can't see anything that Paul says. And Paul can't see anything that Connor says. So, like, when I'm talking to one of them, the other one is just like, what was just said?
Well, no, I only say that if I'm, like, really confused, like a random statement's made. I don't make the connection until, like, seconds later. I'm like, oh, it's because Connor probably said something.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he hasn't.
I think Apple's got to change that. You should be able 100%. To permanently leave a chat and say I'm out. And the
SMS
Android.
Thing.
Yeah, the Android chats you got to be able to leave.
SMS thing is terrible. How you can't leave a text message with an SMS. Like, we're in this one chat.
Android ruins the world, Nick.
With, like, 24 people. No. Probably 18 of them, I have no idea who they are.
Right.
And I'm just stuck in it. It's terrible.
That's the problem. So I have to block everybody in those chats.
Yeah. It's terrible.
But all right.
Apple, get it together.
I'm going to order this thing for Mikey.
All right. See you guys next week.
See you guys.